Hey guys, it's me, Maya, and we are back at it again with another wavy, curly hair kind of video. So we're doing something a little different today. Instead of talking about my hair routines or trying out a product with you guys, I'm gonna be going through a curly hair tag. I just thought that this would be a fun thing to do, answer some questions relating to wavy slash curly hair, and get my opinions out there. So just for some context, I'm getting these questions from Lana Summer's tag video, and I will link her video down below in the description box if you guys are interested in seeing it. But I'm getting my questions from her. She created this tag, and I just thought it would be fun to answer these questions with you guys here on my channel. So let's just jump right into it so you guys can learn more about my thoughts and some products that I use. All right. So number one, name a budget product you love and one that you hate. So a budget product that I love. I absolutely love the Not Your Mother's Sculpting Gel. I used it in my last video. If you guys haven't checked it out, I'll link it down below as well. But I've really been enjoying it. It's a super inexpensive hair gel. I think it's about $7. I got it at Duane Reade, and it was super inexpensive, and it's been working really well. That's what I have in my hair today, and I feel like my hair just feels like really healthy. I don't know. Not that it's a treatment gel or anything, but it just is giving me some great definition, and it's not too stiff. I've been using it every day pretty much, and I've been styling with it for a couple of weeks now, and I've really been liking it. So if you haven't tried it out, I really recommend it. It's awesome. And the next part of that question is, what is one that you hate? So an inexpensive one that I really don't like, and I wanted to like because it's so freaking cheap, is the Eco Styler Gel. And I've tried, I know that there's a bunch of different ones. I've tried, I think, two or three of them. I've tried like the big black bucket one and the big green one, and I think the yellow one. I don't know what they're called. They have a bunch, but I think they're pretty much similar. And the issue that I had with them is just they're really thick gels. So I think it might work better if you have more thick hair or a tighter curl pattern. But for me, it was just weighing my hair down a lot, and it took forever for my hair to dry. My hair is already pretty long, so it takes like 2 to 3 hours for it to dry, maybe four. It takes a while for it to air dry, but with the Eco Styler Gel, it was like it would never dry. It took forever, and it wasn't worth it to me, even though the product itself was inexpensive, and my hair looked okay, but it just felt like so weighed down, and it was not what's up. So in my opinion, I would rather spend a few more dollars and get like the Not Your Mother's one and just love the results. And like you guys can see, it's just really light. I could advertise for them all day. I really like the gel. So one that I recommend for sure, check out the Not Your Mother's styling gel. All right, let's move on to the next question. So the next question, what's a hairstyle you love doing and a hairstyle that you hate doing? All right, so a hairstyle that I love doing would definitely be like an up and down kind of style, like just pinning my hair back like that or pulling it back. That is my like go-to. I'm really big on that. I don't know why, I've always like loved that style. And you can always do like little framing curls. I just feel like it's feminine, it's cute, and it takes like no time. Like you can do that in 1 minute and you're good. And then just style the front a little bit, maybe refresh your curls. But it's really an easy style. So for me, that's like number one priority, is it easy to do? And yeah, it is. And a style that I hate doing, probably space buns, just because I feel like, number one, it's hard to pull off. Like I look I'm looking a little bit too young at that point. And also you need to make sure that you're like getting your part perfect, and you can really like notice the difference. Like for me, it's like, okay, you need the actual buns to be the similar size, the same height. It's like more work than it really you think it will be. So for that reason, I feel like that's my least favorite style to do. That being said, will I never do it? No, I mean, I think it's a cute style. I just think it's a pain in the ass to do. So what's some curly hair advice you love to follow and some curly hair advice you hate hearing? All right, that I love to follow. I'm gonna give you guys two because I don't wanna just stick to one. Number one, I would say, is probably using a microfiber towel. That has been a game changer in my opinion. I used to like not even care what I used on my hair, like just normal bath towel. Like literally I would be that person rubbing my hair and then I wondered why it looked frizzy. I don't know, I really didn't think about it. But now that I actually like scrunch my hair and use a microfiber towel, I've seen such an improvement in my hair and a reduction in frizz. So that's like my number one hair advice, like switch to microfiber towel if you haven't already, or a t-shirt. Either way, just don't use like a normal towel. It will kill your hair. And then my second one that I really like, just because I want to give you guys two, is probably not to brush your hair dry. And I think probably every like curly hair person knows that. Even like wavy haired people know that, but for some reason I didn't. Like a few years back, like 5 years ago, I was on that Marsha brushing my hair all the time, and I don't know why I thought that was like a decent idea. And then I'd be like, oh, my hair's so frizzy. Like, no shit. I really truly didn't know that my hair was like wavy or curly or anything like that. I thought my hair was just like frizzy and it didn't really connect until later. But anyway, those are my two big pieces of advice. I think one's pretty obvious, and maybe both are. Both are probably obvious to anybody with wavy or curly hair, but those are truly the most helpful things for me and things that have reduced my frizz dramatically. Okay, so the next one is, what's a reaction to your hair that you love and a reaction to your hair that you hate? So one that I love is when people that like have known me for years didn't even realize I had wavy or curly hair. Like now that I wear it like this more often, it's really a nice surprise when people are like, oh my god, your hair is so pretty. And one thing that I love that people say is like, oh, what did you do? Did you use like a curling wand? And I'm like, no, this is like how it grows out of my head. And I think a lot of people are surprised by that. Not that my hair looks perfect by any means, but I think it's just like a matter that it's kind of like a wave and a little bit of a curl, or I don't know, but I guess it's because people are used to seeing me with straight hair for like, not now, but maybe like a few years ago when I first started transitioning, people really only saw me with straight hair. And so when I did wear my hair like this, like, oh, what did you do? Did you use like a curling wand? And I'd be like, no, this is my hair. So I really like that reaction because it's usually a positive one. A reaction to my hair that I don't like, and this is probably anyone with wavy or curly hair, is when people suggest that you straighten it or something like that. I don't know, like it's weird. It's like, oh, I really like your hair straight. It's like, okay, so you don't like it curly. I mean, I think a lot of people have heard that kind of thing for years, but for me, you know, it's just a little weird because for so many years I did straighten my hair. So not that it gets to me, but it's just weird to hear because I think, wow, do people see me differently with wavy or curly hair? And like, what do they notice? What do they think about me? It's just interesting because people do have assumptions based off looks, obviously. And I just wonder, what are people thinking? But yeah. All right, next question. What's a styling tool that you love and a styling tool that you hate? So this has changed over the years because for years and years and years, my flat iron was my ride or die. I would straighten my hair every day, but I thought that I was super cool. So instead of just like straightening it flat straight out, I would, you know, like twist the ends and I would create essentially waves and curls with my flat iron. But for me, it looked very like, I don't know, J-Lo-esque or something, where it was like nice and smooth and then like waves at the bottom, you know, like it was very trendy at the time. But now I think that's probably my least favorite hair tool because every time I use it, I just think about the damage that it's doing. And it's probably the most damaging tool you can use because it's literally two plates. So you're really frying your hair. And even though I still do it every now and then, when I do use it, I see such like an impact to my hair that it doesn't really feel worth it. Like my ends will be kind of straight for a few days and my hair just doesn't bounce back. And I know like, I've done damage. So overall, I think that I try to avoid that, and I don't really like my flat iron anymore, which is crazy to hear me say because, like I said, for years and years and years, that was my favorite tool. So then what's my favorite tool now? Probably my blow dryer with my like attachment. So I use a diffuser attachment pretty much always when I use my blow dryer, and I love my blow dryer because it gives me a good amount of volume. Right now, I don't know why my hair is like falling a bit, but overall I feel like I get a decent amount of volume, and I have my blow dryer to thank for that. Not that I blow dry my hair every day, but when I do use it, I see a difference and I like the difference, so that's that. And then the other reason is also that it just saves me time. So when I have hair that's dripping wet, there's nothing I hate more than leaving the house with like wet or damp hair. Like, I actually think it's just gross. So even though it's clean, for me, for some reason, it just feels like disgusting to walk out of the house with wet hair. So I rely on my blow dryer for those reasons, but I don't use it as often as it sounds like I do. Like, I use it maybe once or twice a week. But yeah, even that, I feel like I'm like starting to be like, okay, let me chill out. I don't want to like damage my hair more than it needs to be. So I really am trying to wean off the blow dryer even and just rely on air drying. But I will say it is my favorite tool right now because it helps me out a lot. What's a wash product you love and a wash product you hate? All right, a wash product that I love is probably the current Shea Moisture shampoo that I'm using right now. I'll link it down below, but pretty much I just love a good like conditioning shampoo. Even though it's a shampoo and it's not a co-wash, I really don't really like co-washes because I feel like my hair gets too weighed down with them. What I like about it is it really cleanses my hair well, but it doesn't feel drying at all. Like, my hair doesn't feel squeaky or anything weird like that. It just feels very moisturized and balanced after I use it. So I really love that shampoo and I recommend it. And then what is one that I hate? Probably any shampoo with sulfates. I know that some sulfates are okay, and occasionally I use sulfates to clarify my hair, but I hate how it feels. I absolutely hate it. And growing up, my mom always would buy like Suave shampoo because she was just like living that mom life of buying inexpensive shampoos for kids. And it would strip my hair so badly. So any shampoo with sulfates, but maybe I have a gripe with Suave shampoo specifically. Maybe because they would always say things that sounded appealing, like, oh, it's the Suave Professionals or it's Suave Argan Oil. But in reality, it's like pretty much the same stuff, and it was really harsh on my hair and it left my hair just so frizzy. My hair was a disaster when I was a kid. It was just always frizzy, and I would just tie it back or straighten it. And even when I straightened it, it was so frizzy because I was using such harsh shampoos and conditioners. So lesson learned, definitely not using like dollar shampoo anymore. All right, and then the last question, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I have like multiple hair types. So the last question is, what is your hair type? My hair type, I would say, is like a wavy to curly hair. So right now I definitely have some waves, but there's a few little coily pieces here and there. So I think it ranges from pretty much like a 2B to a 3A depending. And my hair right now is damaged. It's on its road to recovery, but I know that when it's at its healthiest, there's definitely more like 3A pieces here and there, and fewer of like the 2B pieces. So I have a mix for sure, like down in the back of my hair and under, it's more curly, and then some pieces on the side are a little bit more wavy, but that's pretty much what it is. It's like a mix. I don't know. I think a lot of people have like mixed hair types kind of. So it's a little bit all over the place, but it's finding its groove and it's getting on its way to being healthy. Okay, so that's it for today's tag video. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. And if you guys like these questions, make sure to make a video of your own and answer them, or leave answers down below in the comments section to any of the questions. It's always just interesting to hear like what are people's favorite products, what are their like favorite things to use. Because it's always worth trying something else that someone loves. So if a bunch of people love X, Y, and Z, I'm gonna be like trying it out. I'm gonna be like, okay, what's going on here? Like, is this a great product? So leave any suggestions down below in the comment section and I'll be sure to check them out. And that is it for today's video. I hope that you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.